Hello everybody. This is an experiment in electromagnetics and we're studying a phenomenon called Faraday's Paradox, a phenomenon discovered in 1851 by Michael Faraday, the father of electricity. We've got two objectives. One is to demonstrate the Faraday Paradox, which is a simple physics demo, and the other is to investigate a paper made by A.G. Kelly in 1998. And A.G. Kelly claims that there were some things that Faraday missed when he did his original experiments. Now, the A.G. Kelly paper is here, and I've got a copy of this on the website, which is given in the bottom of this video. So you can go and get a copy of the paper, and also you can see a biography of A.G. Kelly, if you so wish. So anyway, moving on to the experiment, what we have here is a repurposed electric drill acting as a motor, which will rotate a disc, which is this disc here, and the disc is rotating in front of a bar magnet. This bar magnet is a ceramic magnet out of a loudspeaker, and I've put a couple of pole pieces on it, mild steel pole pieces, one here and one here, and this is an exact replica of the magnet that Kelly used for his experiment. And so when the disc rotates in the magnetic field, it should give us a EMF generated across the disc, and that will be recorded on the meter here. So let's fire it up and see what we get. Now start the motor. You can see it's doing about 580 RPM, and you can see that the generated EMF is about 3.9 millivolts or so. And that's a straightforward Faraday disc, and nobody disputes that this is how it works. Where we get to the interesting part is when we start rotating the magnet with the disc. The interesting part is if we rotate the magnet at the same time as we do rotate the disc. Now you would expect this would not generate an EMF because now, rather than a disc cutting the lines of force of the field, both the disc and the magnet are rotating together, so there's no relative motion of the conductor through the field, so there should be no EMF generated. So I'm going to shut this down and lock the magnet to the shaft, and we'll co-rotate the magnet with the disc and we'll see what happens. Okay, I have now locked the disc and the magnet to the same shaft, so you can see as I move it back and forth that the magnet and the disc co-rotate. So now you would expect that when I start the motor we would not observe an EMF because the magnet and the rotor are going together, so there's no relative motion. And you can see the brush here is where the EMF is picked up. One contact is on the brush, the other contact is on the metal bearing in which the shaft resides there. So let's start this up and see if we'd get an EMF or not. Surprise, we do get an EMF. We're doing 625 RPM and we've got about 3.9 millivolts of EMF. So that's about the same EMF per unit rotation that we had before. So this is the Faraday paradox. Faraday first observed this, and this is duplicated his experiment of 1851. Now the question is, how can this be? How can it be that you get an EMF even though the magnet's rotating as well? And Faraday came up with the idea that the magnetic field does not itself rotate, but rather is fixed in space. He himself wasn't very satisfied with his explanation, but that's the explanation he gave. We have some more modern explanations of the Faraday paradox, which are based on the way in which Maxwell's equations are interpreted. And so if you put the correct interpretation of Maxwell's equations, it is possible to predict that this will happen. But what you must remember is that this was one of the original experiments on which Maxwell's equations were based. And so it's not really surprising that it obeys Maxwell's equations. That's what Faraday found. Now, let's investigate what Kelly said. And Kelly said that if you route the magnet, if you route the wire through the magnetic field that's rotating, then that will change the EMF that we measure. So let's see if that's the case. I'll start it up. There we have about 630 RPM. 4.05 or 4.1 millivolts. Let's see what happens when we reroute the wire.
Now this is the wire that's connecting to the brush. You can see if I move it around the magnet like this, there's a transient because I'm moving the magnet through the field, but once it settles down to the same voltage it was at before. So we can come straight out this way and then back. Same EMF, or we can come straight out, same EMF. Now, it was Keller's contention that the EMF changed dramatically when we do this, but I am unable to replicate Keller's results.
It's a shame I'm unable to replicate Keller's results, because were they true, it would have some very profound implications. We would have a new energy source, we could have a new space drive, we could have more mundane, we could have a brushless homopolar motor, which would be of huge commercial value. For some reason, it doesn't work when I do it. Keller reported that altering the routing of the wire made a big difference with a co-rotating magnet, but did not make a difference when the magnet was stationary. And that you would expect, because if you put a wire in a static magnetic field, it won't have any EMF generated in the wire. But if you put the wire in a rotating magnetic field, then you will generate an EMF in the wire, and that will change the EMF measured on the meter. But it's not the case in my rig, at least. I find the exact same results that Faraday himself found. Faraday did not report that the EMF changed with rerouting of the wire, and I don't report that either. So if anybody is interested, I've got A.G. Keller's original paper on my website. Also, I have a biography of the man. He was a very respected, well-known engineer. And the website is at emmanuelavionics.org/Faraday. And it says that there should be a link to that in the comments here to this video. So if anybody wants to go and look at that, I've also done a proper write-up of the experiment, so all the paperwork is available and the dimensions and things. And I'd be very much like to hear from anybody who can replicate Keller's results. I could not, but I would love it if somebody could. So anyway, that wraps up the demonstration for today. Thank you for watching.